So it's currently 1:15. Today is Friday, the 25th, and I have planned on going in for the Rundle Street draw of busking spots this afternoon, which I think is either 4 or 4:30. So I basically have 2¾ hours to be there. I am short on time. I need to get myself ready for busking, but I can't help it. I really want to trim off some of this dress. And it's just my brain. I'm like, oh, so excited about that. That's what I want to do. I don't want to do that other thing. I want to do that. So, you know, just in case you were wondering, I know it's a lot. It's a lot up here. So basically, I'm trying to compromise with myself. Like, maybe I can do this for 15 minutes. And hopefully then I've had enough to satisfy this need in my brain. And I can move on to the busking thing, like getting ready for busking thing. Fingers crossed. So firstly, what I'm gonna do, well, I better check, because I've moved this around, that I am at the right height. No, we slightly shorter. So let me just, I think this is a good starting point. So now I'm gonna pin up the top layers here so that I can get at the lining. That is good enough. So now I'm gonna take my pair of scissors and I'm just gonna start chopping. There we go, first cut. Now I have to start working my way around. So it's now 1:40 and this is where I've got it to. I have trimmed off the entire lining and that's what came off of it right there. Now I just want to keep going and I know, stupid. I have 2 hours and 20 minutes till I need to be a gluttony. So I have to get ready. There's just one other thing that I wanted to do. Oh, but I can't. Damn it. Damn it, brain. Also, I did clean up a little bit, but yes, I still have mess in the background. So sorry, I'm not perfect. I'm actually really bad at doing all that. So anyway, that's done. There are actually 2 layers of organza material. So if I let one down, then I can go around and do that layer. This organza is great because you can actually just trim it and you don't have to finish the edge will stay. So it means that hemming organza layers is literally just cutting it off. Amazing. Great. I do want to try, so each one of these, how it's been stitched, there should be like a little knot at the end of each one to stop them from coming off. So how they've got sort of all the different levels and everything, wherever I trim this, I probably want to recreate that, and I should trim off these before I go ahead and actually trim the material and knot them. It's gonna be messy and I just wanna try like one. So maybe I'll try this one over here and see how I go. So basically I will be trimming off to about this level. I am gonna lose some beads on the floor doing this. Okay, so now we've got a break there. I'll go back through and knot them all off. It is Friday again, so. Hello, Lily. 1, 2. Come back and check on it in 15. Yes, Lily, I will let you in. Oh my gosh, hello. Hello. Okay, okay, we're gonna come to the back, okay? And I'll let you in, yeah? Gosh, she's noisy. Love you. Going back to check it. Okay, negative, great. So it's 3:30 and I am thinking in my head now that I'm going to just go in as I am and take part in this draw. And if I get a spot that's too soon, then I'll just
give it away to someone else, but hopefully I get something that's a bit later. I'll come back home, I'll get myself ready, and I'll go in. That's about the only option I have to try this whole draw system, and I really don't want to be like committed to this every week where I stress out about it. So I do want to get it out the road, like giving it a try. Hopefully it all pans out all right, but there's no point in me trying to get ready in 15 minutes. But I've eaten something, I brushed my teeth, so I'm getting ahead with my day now. And 3:30 is not actually so bad given that it's late night shopping and everything, so whatever, I'll just see how it pans out, it's fine.
Not that you can see me, well, very much, I think you can see my eye right there in the corner. Please, 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 let there be a park for me. There is, oh my God, okay. Ticket, 4P. Nope, it's a no stopping zone between 3 p.m. and midnight, Friday to Sunday, so it's now 4, and I cannot park here. I don't know, it says 8 till 6, okay, do you need a ticket here? Okay, let's try again. No, this is insane. They want $10 to park here for the, you know, probably 20 minutes that I'll stay. I'm not doing it. So now I will drive up a bit further. And if I can't find a park, I have just driven around for a half hour drive for no reason. What about this one? Is this anything? This is something. Okay, I can go here. 1 hour for free. Yeah, it's just gonna have to do. Okay, it's now 4:05 and I've got to walk back there. So I will be starting to perform over here at 8:30 and then I will be down near the Exeter at 10. So yeah, that didn't actually end up being too terrible because we get to select our times. We take a coin out of the hat that gives us a number that tells us the order in which we can select our times and our spots. And so yeah, we just went through, I selected 8:30 and then 10, so that gives me 3.5 hours now till my first spot.
I think I said that wrong. The first spot's at 7:30, second spot's at 10. So I go 7:30 to 8:30, I pack up, and then I move, and it'll probably be about 9-ish. And then I start setting up probably about 20 minutes before 10. So I have like 40 minutes there in between, but I figured it was better to do that than to try and do the pack down, move, set up in half an hour because I'm not very good at that. I've got so much stuff and everything. So yeah, I'm going to have a bit of extra time, but that does mean it's now just gone 6. Yeah, 6:03, and I start up at 7:30. So that's an hour and a half away, but I need to have offloaded from my car, got to the spot and started setting up at 7:15. So I basically need to be at the car park at 7:45. That means I need to have left here at 6:30, which is half an hour away. So I am on the clock again. I was like, I'm gonna have 2 hours, whatever. No, I'm gonna have half an hour. So I'm so sweaty and gross. I need to just like wipe myself down, get into my costume, put on my wig, do a little bit of makeup, and yeah, head off. So much for, oh, I'm gonna have all the time in the world. No! And I could have selected 11 on the Exeter spot and then done 8:30. Why, brain, did you not work? Why did you not calculate? It's all right, it's experience. So if I go in tomorrow night or Sunday night or just any night in the future during Fringe, then I will have the wisdom and calculate it out. The amount of time before you actually have the spot to make sure that you can get ready and everything. So I better go do that. And I don't know how much I'm gonna get of it on camera, but you'll probably just see me magically transform. Woo! There we go. I haven't done an ounce of makeup and I think I might just have to leave like this. I put the wig on, I've got some jewelry, I've got the dress on, and yeah, I think I can put a little bit of just lip gloss on my lips because the shade of my lips actually matches quite well in with this dress. I would have liked to have done something with the eyes, but it looks like I'm just gonna have to leave it as is. I could just put like the tiniest touch of eyeshadow on, but it is 6:35. I have booked car parking, so I'm on top of that. I need to take my my batteries, my cameras, and put everything in the car. I have these awesome gloves, which are gonna look amazing, but I'm not putting them on right now. And also, look at this. In case I get overheated on the way down there, which I have a feeling I might. So yeah, okay, let's head off. So I just did the tiniest bit of makeup. You can't really see it, but there we go. It's now 7 o'clock. I should get there at 7:15, which means I have 15 minutes to get from the mall, set myself up and go. So it's not gonna happen. I'm not gonna get to do a full hour in the first spot. But that's just how it is, so we'll deal with it. Changed the plan around and decided that I'm gonna park not where I usually park, but at a closer car park that's open till 1:30 at Target Centrepoint. It's $8 flat rate for the night. And yes, I've already booked the other car park at $5, but you know, losing out on $5, if it means that I can actually get to my spot closer to the time and come back to my car easier at the end, it's totally worth it. So we're here, we're at the car park, everything's everywhere. This is a big mess. This fringe didn't want to do what I wanted it to do. I wanted it to be like really curvy, but it just did not want to do that tonight. So it just is what it is. So yeah, okay.